let's talk about what it means to be pro-life. Now, before you click off, I know this is a political, situation and topic to discuss, but I want to unpack sort of what it means to be pro-life. Because yes, it dives into politics, and I don't like to get political. You'll never hear me endorse a candidate or a particular bill. But I do think that as Christians, we need to be very clear about where we stand on issues of life. To me, pro-life starts with a truth that we as all as Christians have, that human beings are created in the image of God, the Imago Dei, by God and for God. Now, what that means is that being pro-life really has two policy stances as they relate to our United States government. On the one hand, it means that we ought to advocate for an end to abortion. But on the other end, it means that we ought to advocate an end to the death penalty. Now, if you notice there, ending abortion is a typically and traditionally conservative idea, whereas ending the death penalty is a traditionally liberal idea. God doesn't pick sides here, right? So if I'm gonna offend one party, I'm gonna offend every party. Being pro-life means these two things. It means advocating for an end to abortion. So we see throughout scripture that God, even in our mother's wombs, is creating us, is naming us, is giving us a plan and a purpose for our lives. We see in Psalm 139, the psalmist says, God, you knitted me together in my mother's womb. God tells Jeremiah that even before he was born, before he was a thought in his parents' mind, he was outlining and lining up the plans that he had for them. In Luke chapter 1, the John the Baptist leaps in Elizabeth's womb when he encounters Jesus Christ in the womb. There's something sacred, there's something important, there's something beautiful about the sanctity of unborn life from conception. So what that means is that we should be advocating for an end to abortion, but being pro-life means also that we need to have some skin in the game. Which means that we can't just sit on our couches and yell at our TVs that we no longer want 600,000 abortions in our country a year. But that means that we should be actively involved in fostering, that we should care about the adoption community, that we should get involved with young mothers who are considering an abortion in crisis pregnancy centers. We've got to love them, we've got to cherish them, and not just the life that is growing inside of them. Let me also just say that being pro-life means that if you have had an abortion, and stats will say now that between about 1 in 4 women will in their lifetime, listen, we love you. God's grace is for you. You have not committed an unforgivable sin. You've committed a sin just like I've committed a sin. So that means we welcome you, we love you, we cherish you just as we believe that God does as well. But being pro-life also means that we ought to advocate for an end to the death penalty. Now, I've heard and I've believed at times in my life the argument, well, an unborn human life hasn't committed any crime, whereas an inmate sitting on death row has. So clearly that person is deserving of death, whereas the unborn child is not. And while I see some logic in that argument, I believe that we as Christians should push back against that and say, look, the gospel says that we are all sinners, that not one of us is innocent. We are all guilty in the eyes of God, but by the blood of Jesus Christ, we are covered and we are forgiven, no matter what our sin is. And we also see time and time again folks that are exonerated from death row who are heading in that direction in our country towards state-sanctioned death and then are proven innocent of the crime that they were committed of. Stats will say that over 200 people have been wrongly executed in our country. And we shouldn't be okay with that. We should actively be involved in trying to end both abortion and the death penalty. And listen, pro-life has a whole lot of other kind of daily ways to live out this belief that we are all made in the image of God. It means things like we should care for the orphan in our midst. We should care for the immigrant, for the migrant in our midst, for the prisoner, for those who are hurting, for those who have had an abortion. All people are created in the image of God, worthy of His grace, worthy of our mercy and our care and being for them. Hey, if you'd like to talk about this talk or really anything else, shoot me an email. I'd love to grab coffee or lunch with you sometime so that we can seek God's truth together.